Hello all, this is James Johnson, aka Sulfurblade, and welcome to Planet Zoo. I've just started a franchise mode in the beta branch of the game. I'm going to go ahead and pause things. Or did I start things? I think I'm paused. All right, so yeah, Planet Zoo, kind of like Planet Coaster and all those other games. This is another similar game in that vein. I'm playing in the franchise mode, which is, I'm assuming, I have to make money and manage the zoo's financials. It's got to be profitable, etc., etc. And from what I understand, there's a certain amount of conservation involved in the game, where you're actually trying to teach your visitors about the animals, and even trying to possibly release some endangered species back into the wild as you're breeding them here at the zoo. So with that being said, let's just jump on in and try to make the most awesome zoo ever, shall we? So much stuff. I should probably read this. Welcome to Planet Zoo's franchise mode, and thank you for taking part in beta. Go and play the tutorial. Seriously, it's a good idea. Probably should. Franchise mode. In franchise mode, you'll be able to build your dream zoo from scratch. Adopt animals from the trade center. Adopt your starting breeding animals of your own. Put them up for adoption by other players. Cash will be tight, so you have to start small and work your way up the more prestigious animals. Planet Zoo currencies. There are two types of currencies in franchise mode. There's cash, brought into the zoo by guests. These are used to purchase entry, buy food, drink, souvenirs, make donations. After having had good views of the animals, cash is the lifeblood of your zoo. It allows you to build the infrastructure, hire staff, and purchase some animals. Conservation credits. These are obtained through challenges, daily logins, trading with other players, and importantly, releasing animals to the wild when they are in their prime. Conservation credits are used to adopt high-tier animals and trade with other players. Helpful hints. Donation boxes. Make sure to place donation boxes near habitat viewing locations, otherwise you'll not generate your zoo's full potential. Placing staff facilities. Placement of staff facilities is really important. Staff walking between jobs is incredibly inefficient, so keep their facilities near to where they have to work. Work zones. Staff are at their most efficient when constrained to areas of work. Use the work zone system to make sure they're focusing on what you need them to do and not undertaking too many disparate jobs. Power both staff and guests facilities, plus a number of other objectives, including exhibits, require power to function. The effective range of power systems is what is and isn't covered, can be seen using the heat map mode. Guest happiness. Guests will get really unhappy if they walk near any staff facility, including power and water treatment. You can see how these items are impacting your zoo by using the heat map. Use staff paths to separate these working areas from the guest areas. Animal welfare. Make sure your animals have enough living space and check their other needs. Happy animals also equal happy guests, and happy guests spend more money. Animals with low welfare will not breed and may attract protesters who will make your guests unhappy. Trading animals. You'll need a trade center to acquire animals. Animals adopted or moved to the trade center storage, which has a limited capacity, and you will then need to have them move to a suitable habitat. Staff. Each of your staff members have their own roles, and you will need each of them to maintain and successfully run your zoo. For instance, you'll need caretakers to transport animals and keep litter off the paths, which will help keep your guests happy. Thanks for reading. There's a lot of additional information in the help text in Zoopedia in case you get stuck. Have fun and great breeding, Planet Zoo Team. Staff alerts. So we need a keeper's hut, a trade center, vets. You need a vet surgery, quarantine, workshop, research center, and staff center. Guest facilities, staff facilities, benches, utilities, viewing distance, transfer rides. Where are there's my paths? What have I done? Hey, what happened to all that path information? Make the paths wider. stamp is. Here we go. That place is a bit expensive and doesn't fit. Oops. How do I turn this damn thing? Control does something. Alright, the controls are a little obtuse. I would think Q and E would rotate, but they don't. Right mouse doesn't do anything. So we have a staff place, right? Planet Zoo staff building, Planet Zoo veterinary surgery. Research center. All right, that's better. Says we need a workshop, so Alright, so we got those staff buildings in. The Keeper's Hut I want to put actually closer to the enclosure. My first enclosure, that is. Which we should probably build one of those. We're here at the very beginning. We want to start with, I would say, the cute animals, the pretty animals, the animals that are like decorative but not dangerous. So let's go with a hedge. And we might want to lower the height on the hedge here. Isn't there a way to make it like 90 degrees? Perfect. Obstructed? Why is it obstructed? That's just to make it harder to see the staff area. Basically trying to hide the staff area. Okay, now paths. We need to get back to staff pass. There we go. Alright, what's a nice welcoming type animal that we can toss in here? We also need some sort of door. Thank you. one connecting object, huh? Alright, we've got some initial staff. Now we need some animals to put in here. These peafowl seem like a good one. How do I put them in here? Alright, now they should be getting moved in. Where are they? And the magic birds out of the boxes. There we go. Hungry, thirsty, welfare, habitat. Here we go. So yeah, they wouldn't mind a little more soil, grass. No, it's too much long grass. Not enough short grass. This is short. Okay, we got more short grass, and they're happy about that. Soil. Maybe short grass? Is that what it's saying? Thank you. Train's not bad. It's pretty good. No hard shelter. Alright, plenty of shelter, good terrain. Now we need to get them stuff. So I need to somehow find a way to sort by. Now, if I'm correct, these birds will have everything that they need in here. Too few adults, so we need another peacock. Oh, here's some males. Nice. So, will this extra male peafowl be enough to make them socially happy? He's the pretty one, huh? is the target temperature? And it's in Celsius. Where to adjust that? I don't see a way to put it in Fahrenheit. Damn it! Europeans. Rest of the world. So, is there a way to see what he likes for temperature so I know what to target? That's what I'm looking for. Three to 30, okay. So now we're researching the peacock. Good. I think we have successfully created a peacock exhibit. Is there anything we can mix in with them? With an elephant and a rhinoceros. Well, I'm certainly not wanting to put elephants and rhinoceroses in this type of an enclosure. So, that's not happening. I wonder if there's a reason I can't put an ostrich in with him. I suppose I could try, see what happens. What kind of habitat do they like? Eight to 40, so temperature wise we're fine here. Meters squared. Is it going to be big enough? So peacock likes a much smaller. How many male vanish? 1 to 2. I'm going to try to throw 2 peacocks in on them. Why does these ones have ribbons? What's so special about them? Let's see how ostriches and peacocks do together. That one ostrich is way bigger. I think this is gonna work. Alright, we need to get donation boxes and signs up. Alright, let's watch our first exhibit for a little bit. Alright, so they're absolutely right. I'm going to need the standard mist runes. Toilets are expensive. My gosh. Alright, so now our second enclosure, it's time to start putting it in. Is there another animal that would be good for a low-key animal that's not gonna be too much of a threat? What animals do we have to work with here? levels are pretty low key. Anything I can mix in with them? The height adjusting. Why isn't the height changing, damn it? God, this is obtuse. Let me Oh. It's dragon. Stop bending, just make it straight. is this path so big all of a sudden? I just put a gate in. Didn't I put a gate in?
Oh, Jaames, switching the cup to tail.
Let's see if we're making any money. We're still doing research. Okay. Alright, so we have two enclosures. We've got a turtle enclosure, we've got peacocks and ostriches over here. So far no really exciting animals, but, you know, friendly-ish animals that we can put a nice small hedge here and the people can get somewhat close to without any fear of anything bad happening. Petting zoo type animals, though. We're not exactly letting the people pet them. So, next on the list, I'm thinking, let's look at our Zoopedia and see what we have to work with here. I'm thinking lemurs. Alright, we'll let the path go on a little curve here, just to give it, you know, some interestingness to it, I suppose. Alright, let's toss some lemurs in here, shall we? Alright, we got two lemurs being delivered. Alright, you little guys, what do you want here? You... not thrilled about your terrain and your habitat. You want a lot more soil. Seem to think that they have enough hard shelter already. Interesting. Okay, he's happy with that. So we'll check our animals.
Yeah.
They seem to be quite happy with that tree. There isn't much to see in this view, in the zoo, huh? Yep, it's still a pretty small, basic zoo. Making money yet? Income, ongoing expenses. I think we are. We have a positive income. I think it's time to get another. Another keeper. Alright, this is probably a good spot to end episode 1. So we have added lemurs to the zoo, we have added ostriches, we have added peacocks, and we have added giant tortoises. We have 4 species. Of those species, the lemurs are probably the biggest draw. None of them are really predators, none of them are really scary. If I was going to this zoo, I probably wouldn't. It's not exactly very exciting yet. But you gotta start small. You gotta work up to the big attractions. And those are gonna come in the next episode. So please stay tuned as we continue our adventures inside of the brand new game, Zoo Planet. This is coverage of Zoo Planet Beta. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, please leave a like and subscribe. And until the next time, all, peace.